I'm a huge X-Men fan. I grew up knowing the comics and loving the world and, of course, the movies. So I was really excited that they were bringing in the Apocalypse storyline. And also Psylocke, because she has always been one of my favorite X-Men characters. You know Psylocke, you know that her storyline is very diverse and layered, and she's a fascinating character. But simply, she is a telepath, telekinetic mutant, and she has this amazing ability to create anything with her mind, which is something that she uses when she creates her sword with her hand. So the thing I've always loved about Psylocke is that, unlike a lot of superheroes and even villains where they don't want to kill, but they will if they have to, Psylocke, I think, has always enjoyed it or has no problem doing it. You know, she can create anything with her mind to stop someone, so she could kill from afar like Storm or Magneto, but she chooses to create a sword with her hand so she can kill up close. That's a very intimate way to kill someone, and you know, that's why Psylocke has always been one of the fiercest superheroes out there and fiercest in the X-Men universe, because she's very lethal, she's an amazing fighter, she's got, you know, ninja assassin skills, and she's not afraid to get her hands dirty. Apocalypse is collecting his four horsemen, myself being one of them, and Apocalypse has a mission, and that is to eradicate the Earth of ex-mutants, or non-mutants. The four horsemen are Magneto, Angel, Storm, and myself, and Apocalypse needs the four horsemen the same way that the four horsemen, you know, were used in the biblical sense. And, you know, if Apocalypse is the godfather, then, you know, we're the capos. So that's kind of the I think the easiest way to explain it. But he, you know, he needs us to do his bidding. Charles has the strongest power, which is, you know, he can get into people's minds. And Apocalypse wants that. And it's very simple. I would want it as well. I started training. I've never done sword work before. And I started doing all of the sword work and then wire and stunt training, and then going and doing taekwondo and karate and boxing. When we started doing the costume for Psylocke, we didn't have much time before shooting. And there was a moment where they said, well, we need to get the look right, which is very important, because when you're doing these costumes, they have to fit you like a glove, and they have to be a second skin. So it takes a lot of fittings, a lot of practice, a lot of people working really hard to make it fit. Now the latex comes in black, like it's standard black color. So the option to make her a version of purple or blue was on the back burner. It was like, if we have time. And I got on the phone with Brian and I said, Brian, I understand that there's an element of let's take inspiration from the comics, but also create her in our own way, and create, that's what they do for all the costumes. They go, but specifically for Psylocke, I feel like the way she looks is so indicative to who she is and so iconic in the X-Men universe and people who love that world, that if you're going to create this character, you have to give the people what's in their head. Simon Kinberg is the man. He's so clever, and he's so smart, and he's such a good guy.
Hey guys, did you know that Pierce Brosnan was contractually forbidden from wearing a full tuxedo in any non-James Bond movie from 1995 to 2002? For this and more movie facts, click on more videos. But if you want something else, click on the playlist.